Moon River, wider than a mile, I'm crossing you in style someday.
It's the Oscar Johnny Mercer won for The Days of Wine and Roses. We're listening to Moon River, which was another Oscar-winning song from the movie Breakfast at Tiffany's. We're standing in the Johnny Mercer corner of the Savannah History Museum, and this show is a tribute to Johnny Mercer. This week is a festival. The Set Sail for Savannah group has put together Savannah Swings with the Johnny Mercer Festival. So over the next 30 minutes, we're going to tell you a lot about the festival. You'll learn a little bit about Johnny Mercer and find out what this town meant to him and what he meant to the people in it. So we're going to go away from the corner here and actually sit over in a different corner of the Johnny Mercer Hall of Fame here and talk a little bit about the Savannah Swings with the Johnny Mercer Festival. So stay tuned. The same. We're sitting in the Johnny Mercer corner of the Savannah History Museum, and I'm sitting here with Sherry Sprecher, who's the festival chairman, or the festival chairperson, I should say, for the Savannah Swings with Johnny Mercer Festival. Now, I got to get this straight because this is really important.
Okay.
The Savannah Swings with the Johnny Mercer Festival is a part, or part and parcel, connected with the Set Sail for Savannah, right?
Yes.
Now, this organization, correct me if I'm wrong, this organization is Mayor Weiner's special events program of festivals to try and help beef up the festivals that are being done here in Savannah.
Mm-hmm.
Am I right so far?
So far, you're doing great.
Doing fine so far. Okay, good. But the interesting thing about the Set Sail for Savannah Swings with Johnny Mercer Festival is that this particular show, this festival coming up, has been endorsed by the Johnny Mercer Foundation.
Out in Hollywood, yes.
Out in Hollywood, and Mrs. Elizabeth Mercer.
Mm-hmm.
That's heavy stuff.
Oh, it's pretty impressive. June Whitworth and Kathy Ann Edwards have done a wonderful job with Set Sail. The mayor's choice of having, or the idea of having a committee established just to do special events has just been, it was a wonderful idea, and now it's a reality because the Set Sail has come up with the Savannah Swings for Johnny Mercer, and it's off the ground, and we're literally running.
It's flying. It's flying this week. We're recording this literally 1 week before. One week before the big concert,
uh-huh.
Mel Torme coming. We'll talk about that in a minute. But as part of this, also, I understand that Executive Vice President of the Johnny Mercer Foundation, Bobby Weinstein, is going to be here to, and I'm going to read my notes here, to accept the Founders Award, or is Foundation to accept the President, June, am I right? To present the Founders Award for the Songwriters Hall of Fame? And that's going to go to Johnny posthumously. Big stuff.
Funny you should mention, I have the letter right here.
What's it say?
The Songwriters Hall of Fame. To Ms. June Whitworth, Project Director, Savannah Swings with Johnny Mercer Festival. Dear June, this letter is to confirm that I will be coming to Savannah to present an award to Charles Tigerman, Vice President of the Mercer Foundation. This award is an exclusive, one-time only award that is being presented posthumously to our founding president, Johnny Mercer.
Wow.
The Board of Directors and I take great pleasure in participating in the Savannah Swings Festival honoring Johnny Mercer, which coincidentally is happening at the same time as our silver anniversary.
I'll be done.
So it's really neat. The Songwriters Hall of Fame was founded in 1969 by publishers Abe Ullman, Howard Richmond, and songwriter Johnny Mercer.
I'll be done.
We continue to pursue the dream. I look forward to an eventful festival. Warmest personal regards, Bobby Weinstein. Incidentally, the chairman of the board of directors is Frank Sinatra.
Old blue eyes, can't argue with that. Well, this is the work that you folks and June Whitworth have done to pull people together for this. It's from what I've been seeing on the outline, of course we're helping out as much as we can, but an outsider looking in, it's an outpouring of love like I've never seen for a group to Well, for another individual, especially in show business like this, we know that Johnny was founders of the Songwriter Hall of Fame. We found that, but he was quite a man. And the local memories, and we've been taping this morning with so many people who just have memories of Johnny that are great. The Savannah Swings with Johnny Mercer Festival, but it, other than just the homage to the great man, you guys have jammed all kinds of activities into this week coming up.
Oh, it's just amazing. It has developed a life of its own. We have, for instance, the Mercer Media Night with the Savannah Cardinals, which is going to be a fun thing because we're going to be raising money for the Coastal Children's Advocacy Center for Abused
That's
Children.
Wonderful.
This April is Abused Child Prevention Month, and it's going to be a little Savannah Nielsen rating. So all of the media are getting their employees, their staff, their fans, their listeners, their watchers, and they're getting them all out, and they have to go there and vote. And then the winner of that will get bear the top media dog of 1994 bragging rights for the rest of the year, which is going to be a fun thing, and everybody always has fun
and
with the
Wednesday
Savannah Cardinals.
Night, right? Wednesday the 20th.
Gotcha. At 7:15. Okay, and then from there we have on Thursday we have a wonderful outdoor concert with the Armstrong State Jazz Ensemble. This is a free event. Thursday night at the Savannah Theater, Julie Wild has put together a marvelous review, dance review of with Mercer music, interspersed with Daddy Longlegs shots. It's going to be really fun. An event out. Johnny Harris is doing a Johnny Mercer dance. That's a natural. We have a barbershop quartet out at Armstrong. It's just amazing how it's grown. But really, the big night tonight, we have a number of things going on. The Mercers at the Hilton has a special show. But tomorrow is our big day, and it starts with the Georgia State Jazz Orchestra arriving in Savannah about 12:30, and then we're going to put them on the Mercer Mobile. That's one of the green and orange trolleys, and we're going to cruise around the downtown historic area playing Mercer music, and then we're going to go out to Stillwell Towers, and they're going to give a free concert for the elderly out there. And I understand Golden Age Services has managed to get other people, and they're going to ferry them from the other high-rises and elderly places so they can all enjoy this. And of course, it's a free concert.
Sure.
And then after that, there is the VIP reception here with Mel Torme. John Barrett, who is one of our committee members, is going to be here. Curtis Atkinson is the Assistant Secretary of State, and just all kinds of great people from our wonderful community to celebrate this. And Ben Tucker and Emma Kelly are going to be playing during that. And then from the VIP reception, we move over to the Radisson. And at the Radisson, the DeSoto Hilton has sponsored the Georgia State University Jazz Orchestra community concert there. This is also free. Dick Conrad and Fred German are going to be emceeing that from WLOW. And then we move into the concert proper in the Grand Ballroom. Stand up and take a bow for Peach State Public Radio, WSVH and WWIO, for whom the concert is a benefit.
You bet. It's great.
And it opens with Ben Tucker and Emma Kelly, and then we have the Chris Chandler Connection. We have the very best that Savannah has to offer, and of course then we have Mel Torme, and we're all really waiting for that. It's just so exciting, the fact that he's coming here. He's coming here because Johnny Mercer helped get him started.
Right.
It was, of course, you know, Johnny Mercer started Capitol Records, too. So, I mean, you know, just it's just so exciting to be celebrating one of Savannah's most favorite, most loved sons.
For those of us who are big fans of Mel Torme, and were a long time before Night Court ever came on the air, I want to add, this is a dream come true for them to come in. And it was a real treat for me to have been given the opportunity to talk to Mr. Torme about a week ago about his upcoming show and about Johnny. And his feelings towards Johnny, again, just an outpouring of heartfelt affection and respect, a tremendous amount of respect. And I think I can honestly say that he's really looking forward to coming down to Savannah, because he said he's really looking forward to that trip. We even have some audio of that interview that I did with Mr. Torme about a week ago. So here's a little snippet of some of the feelings that he has about Johnny, and kind of a preview of what he's got planned for the upcoming concert.
I got to know Johnny Mercer during World War II here in Hollywood. There used to be a conclave of songwriters that would get together on Sunday afternoons, at a little club called the Encore on La Cienega Boulevard in Hollywood. And the purpose of this meeting, this gathering, was the fact that on Sundays, they would indulge in what we used to call instant lyric writing.
Wow.
And by that I mean that a melody would come forth, and instantaneously, right there, right on the spot, they would make up lyrics to go with the melodies. Well, of all the great songwriters that appeared at those little meetings, Johnny Mercer was the king, the absolute king. Everything that he came up with was brilliant and funny and touching and just a work of art. I got to know him in those days and, of course, knew him for the rest of his life and was absolutely in awe of him, because I think he's the greatest lyric writer this country ever turned out. He was wonderfully mirthful. He was a great sense of humor, which of course shows up in his lyric writing. He could also be very serious. He was a contemplative man. He was a guy that read everything he could lay his hands on so that he would be more armed with the properties of lyric writing. He once said to me, if you want to write good lyrics, just read everything possible. The comic strips, Time magazine, the great authors, everything. And that was very good advice, because I think that When the World Was Young is the most evocative, sentimental piece of music and lyrics that I've ever heard in my life. It recalls the time when you were young. I mean, I don't know how old you are, but I'm getting there. And it's, as I say, it's evocative of a time that was perhaps a little better in your life. Life was a little better. The world was a little better. And it promptly brings up pictures to the mind that are absolutely mind-boggling. So that song, probably more than any Mercer tune, well, I shouldn't say tune, Mercer lyric,
right,
is very dear to me. It's something that I sing all the time and something that I care very deeply about. He wrote a wonderful song for a movie called Star Spangled Rhythm with Bing Crosby and, incidentally, just about every star in the Paramount lot. This is back in, I think 42, but don't hold me to that.
Okay.
And he wrote a song called Life is Fine with My Baby on the Swing Shift. And it tickles me. He goes, Life is fine with my baby on the swing shift. So divine with my baby on the swing shift. She's the nuts. They're among those nuts and bolts. With 100 million volts shining from her eyes, she's an interceptor. I mean, what kind of a mind dredges up lyrics like that? I mean, it's incredible. Sondheim is a great songwriter, there's no doubt about it, and you can't deny his power or his talent. But he's not in Johnny Mercer's class, I'm sorry. And as a matter of fact, neither is anybody. Think about this. Mercer, who wrote Laura is the face in the misty light, footsteps that you hear down the hall, also wrote Glow Little Glowworm, Glimmer, Glimmer, and all the rest of the lyrics that went with that glowworm thing. Now, one day, I was driving around. You read my book, so you know what I'm talking about. I was driving around Hollywood, listening to the radio in my car. And on came an announcer who said, now, here is Mario Lanza and his version of Song of India. Now, Mario Lanza is not exactly my musical cup of tea, but I did listen. When it was over, I drove into a mobile gas station, got out of my car, went to the phone, called the radio station, and said, please, for God's sake, tell me who wrote that lyric. Well, of course, it was Johnny Mercer. What I'm saying is that he had such scope, such a breadth, B-R-E-A-D-T-H, such a breadth of talent that he could write down-home lyrics like My Mama Done Told Me When I Was in Knee Pants and turn around and write Song of India. When I heard that lyric, I walked back to my car, got in it, and said to no one in particular, well, I never have to go to India. Everything I ever wanted to know about India, I just heard in that Johnny Mercer lyric. And he wrote little cute novelty tunes like Jeepers Creepers and Goody Goody. He wrote bravura ballads like You're Clear Out of This World, and of course Laura and That Old Black Magic. I mean, he was a man for all seasons. He could write virtually anything that came up in the way of an assignment. Somebody would say, listen, we're doing this movie, and could you write a song called The Days of Wine and Roses?
Oh, yeah.
And bingo, there it came.
Right.
He was phenomenal. He was just phenomenal.
As you can see, I think, or as you can hear anyway, Mel Torme is excited about coming down here and brings just a tremendous, just a tremendous power to the Savannah Swings with Johnny Mercer Festival. And interesting to note that we need to make sure you know that other than the Mel Torme concert, which is only $20 a ticket, cheap, for a concert of this caliber, and maybe the baseball game on the 20th, everything else is free to the public. Just about everything else is free to the public. Thanks to...
Oh, thanks to all of the people in the community, the business people in the community, the entertainers, friends of Mercer, people who are just Mercer fans. Everyone has contributed so much that we have essentially $250,000 festival with very little cash exchanged.
That's incredible.
Just from the contributions that our community has made to celebrate its favorite son.
You bet. Big, big hats off and a big thank you to all the local businesses, educational foundations, single persons, entertainers, everybody.
Oh, the school system.
The schools, you bet. Anybody who's helped out and you know who you are, a mighty big thank you for that. We mentioned at the top of the show that the Mercer Foundation has given us their
sanction, blessing.
Foundation support and blessing. As part of that, we've been able to arrange an interview with Johnny Mercer's wife. Mrs. Ginger Mercer is still alive and living in Los Angeles. And thanks to our Cablevision connection out there in LA, we were able to get a hold of her and pick up some comments and some memories from her. And we've also got some comments from longtime friend and Mercer music performer Margaret Whiting through the wonders of cable up in Manhattan.
In New York,
and,
yes.
Paragon Manhattan up in New York. And I think this might be a good time to hear what Ginger Mercer's comments are.
Okay.
Should we do that? Let's roll that tape.
If it isn't all of us, he went to a prep school called Woodbury Forest. In Orange, Virginia. So then he graduated cum laude. Was supposed to go to college. But was studying Cato in New York. That was where I met him. I'm the theater guild, produced a show called The Garrick Gaylies. A very small show. I was a dancer. And we met, and he would take me home in a taxi. He wrote lots of it in those days, especially since he had no money. He was very, very talented. He was always thinking of a song.
Is there a personal favorite song of yours? One that sticks out that you liked maybe more than anything else?
I remember you.
Didn't you know? Wonderful thoughts, warm thoughts from Mrs. Ginger Mercer. We really appreciate her taking the time to do that. We also have an interview that was done recently with Miss Margaret, the legendary Mrs. Margaret Whiting, who is also on the board of directors for the Songwriters Hall of Fame, and vice president of
the Mercer Foundation.
The Mercer Foundation. And we taped an interview with her up in Manhattan, so let's take a look at that.
How do I know Johnny Mercer? Well, I met him when I was 7 years old, and he came out to Hollywood to write songs with my father, Richard Whiting. He had said when they asked him if he would like to work with Richard Whiting, he says, yes, because he was a great golfer and I can brush up on my swing. And when I was about seven, I sang for him one night at a party at our house. And after I finished, I was scared stiff. And he said, come here. Come on over. And I went over to him in the corner and he says, Margaret, I want to give you two words of advice. Grow up. Which, looking at me, you can tell I did. And from that moment on, he became my mentor, my guide to everything. And, well, we were very best friends. I loved him. I can never forget him. And he was the genius in my life that did so much for so many people. When I was about 14, I started at Capitol Records. He had coached me and told me singers to listen to so I could get my own style. And when I was 14, he signed me to Capitol Records when it started. And I had to wait a while because he said, I have to find a very, very special song for you to sing first. So about a year later, I was waiting around and Peggy Lee was signed and Joe Stafford was signed and Ella Mae Morris made the first record and she had a million seller on it. And I kept popping around. He says, just relax, your time will come. And one day he called me down to the studio and he said, Margaret, I have the song for you. And he handed it to me and I said, what? My ideal? My father's my ideal? I said, Sinatra recorded it. Marie Chevalier recorded it. And he said, and you're going to record it. And we got lucky. But it was my first million seller. I loved It Might As Well Be Spring and Tree in the Meadow, which was a big English hit for me. And let me see, I had 12 that sold over a million. One of my favorites was I'm in Love with a Wonderful Guy, which was from South Pacific. And I loved Faraway Places, and I adored a record I made with him called Baby, It's Cold Outside. I think one day I went to a meeting with Hank Mancini, and it was for the Grammys. And we were both on the board. This is my favorite Johnny Mercer story because if he'd paid any attention to me, I could have stopped maybe one of the greatest songs from being published. So Hank said, Margaret, Johnny wants to come by when we're through the meeting and would like you to hear our new song. So I said, sure. So we waited a few minutes after the meeting was over and in came Johnny and he said, hiya, kid. And, you know, so Hank sat at the piano and Johnny stood up and sang Moon River. And he said, what do you think? Because he always, after his wife Ginger, he'd ask me what I thought of the songs. So I loved the song, and I was trying to think what to say, and he said, now I know you. I know you for a long time. There's something wrong with this song. And I said, it's the most gorgeous lyric and a beautiful melody. He said, but what is it? I said, it's that lyric, Huckleberry Friend. I said, honest to goodness, I don't think that's good. I think that throws the song completely out of context. I said, I think it'll hurt the song. And he said, well, that's a good thought, Margaret. Now, I'm going to go home, and I'll call you later on. So Mancini had, when I said that, had fallen over the piano like, oh, my God, what have you done to this man with his lyric? But I was very sincere about it. So a few hours later, he called me at the house and he said, well, kid, you may not like this, but I'm going to stick with my feelings, my ESP. I think Huckleberry Friend is good. So I said, okay, if you feel that way. Now, a few months later, I saw my mother in the market and she said, Margaret, I just heard Johnny's new song. It's wonderful. She went on and on and, oh, it's marvelous. And I said, well, what's it called? She said, it is going to win the Academy Award. It's going to be a big hit. It's a smash. I said, what is it called? She said, Huckleberry Friend. So I knew right then and there that I had made a mistake, although it was called Moon River, because that's where the girl lived that was in Breakfast at Tiffany's. How do I feel when I sing Blues in the Night? I just remember the last time I, not the last time I saw Johnny, but when he and Harold Arlen came over to my house one day to play it for me. And Judy Garland was there, and Mickey Rooney, and Martha Ray, and Mel Torme. And when we were through, when they played the song for us, Mel just sat on the floor. He couldn't get up. Martha Ray, for once, never opened her mouth. Mickey Rooney just walked around the room saying, "I can't believe it. I can't believe it." And Judy and I raced to the piano to see who could learn it first. But it's immortal, that song. It's history. And I just am proud whenever I sing it, and I love it. I think he's the, well, I'll go on record as saying I think Johnny Mercer was the greatest genius that we've had in the songwriting business.
Another wonderful interview. Just Mrs. Whiting, I know you can't hear me, but I'll say thank you anyway. And thank you, Sherry Sprecher, the festival director for the Savannah Swings with Johnny Mercer Festival.
Well, thank you, Larry, and thank Cablevision. We really appreciate all the support that Cablevision has given us. And just keep an eye on the town crier schedule, and it will give you minute-by-minute, blow-by-blow description of every single event we have coming up this week.
Well, we're excited about helping you guys out. We also might mention that if you're a Music Choice customer, tomorrow from 5 to 6 and also from 11 to 12 p.m., if you turn to the Big Band Nostalgia channel, you'll hear nothing but Johnny Mercer music for an hour, for 2 hours, 1 hour at 5 and 1 hour at 11. So I'll give you kind of a tasty tidbit. We also have one more honored guest who was willing to come down and give us a couple of comments on the festival. So let's hear what Mayor Weiner had to say.
Johnny Mercer said it best. Pardon my southern accent. I guess I don't have one. Pardon my southern drawl. Well, I certainly don't have one of those. Now, it may be funny, but I swear to you, honey, come rain or come shine, we love you all. Johnny Mercer, Savannah Swings with Johnny Mercer. Come out to the festivities. Finally, this city is honoring our great son. Come join us.
Well, we hope that everyone will come out for the Savannah Swings with Johnny Mercer Festival this week. As you can see, there is something for everybody to pay tribute to a man who's one of Savannah's favorite sons, a beloved person, and a warm, warm human being. The Savannah Swings with Johnny Mercer Festival, I guess you could only use Johnny's words in saying, it's just too marvelous for words. We'll see you there.
You heartbreaker, wherever you're going, I'm going your way. To drifters off to see the world, there's such a lot of world to see.